Today we'll learn how to transform this into this using AI. To start, we're going to use a render that I have created using Twinmotion 2025. This is a scene that's part of our Twinmotion course. If you're interested in learning how to generate this type of interactive experiences and photorealistic renders like the one we're seeing using path tracing, well, I invite you to discover more about the course in the comment section and in the description of this video. But let's get straight to the point, to what we are going to talk today. To create this animation, we're going to use today this platform, which is known as Flow. Flow is the video generation system that allows us to use the Google VO model that lately it's so trending, like VO2 and especially VO3, which has been recently launched. However, you should know that this is not a completely free service. You must have a Google Pro or Google Ultra subscription. In this case, we're going to be using the Google AI Pro subscription, which is a bit more affordable, but especially because we currently have an offer that Google gives us 1 month completely for free, in which we are going to be able to try all these tools so you can find if they are truly valuable for your workflows. And well, you have to keep in mind that it also includes 2 terabytes of storage in Drive and Gemini tools and many other things. At the moment, we're not interested in this, but you must know it's quite an interesting subscription. For now, we're going to access the tool. Once you have an account with your free plan or your trial plan, we go to the Create with Flow tool. And what will appear here is the interface of this Google Labs tool. As we can see here, you will get 1,000 AI credits to be able to use them in all this content creation. However, at this moment, well, I have 600 credits because I've already created some projects. I've already used them. And we are going to see how the consumption of these credits work. To begin, you will have to create a new project. In this case, I've already created one with some results so we can analyze them little by little to understand how this tool works. And well, so what you're going to see mainly is that you will have this box like in any other AI tool where we write a prompt, and from certain parameters, we're going to perform a generation. This can be text to video, but this will result in outputs that don't make much sense with what we want to achieve, since it will be a completely imaginary result from the AI system. What we want is for it to convert images or frames into videos. We're going to review then each one of the results to understand how they work and how they were created among themselves. To be able to do this, I'm going to press this little button that's here, which will reuse the prompt information that I've made to generate this result. In this case, what I've done is, well, I've selected frame to video. I've written a brief description of what I want to happen. For example, here, a timelapse scene from day to night and moving clouds. Also add some birds and a plane very far away, moving in the background, so breeze, so plants and trees move. This will generate the moving effect that I want, and I've also added a first frame. This first frame that I've loaded, if you click here on it, this plus button, you will be able to load the images, and it will determine what that initial image will be from which the AI model will rely to generate the rest of the content. This is the original, this is the first image, but the rest will be completely generated, and this will help us to that what is generated will emerge from this image. We also have here a tool to choose the AI model and how many outputs there will be per prompt. Important, we currently have this VO2 model and the VO3 model, which evidently the VO3 model offers much higher quality in the results. But we have to keep in mind that each and one of these tools we have here, each one of these models have a different credit price per generation. It's completely different. You can see here, if you click on this hyperlink, well, a table that shows how many credits each type of generation requires for each model. Here you can see that, for example, using the VO2 fast model, we'll have up to 100 generation. because it only needs 10 credits per generation. But models like VO3, Fast, which is more realistic, much better, will only allow you to use 10 video generations, because the credits it needs are 100 per generation. However, for all the results that I've created in this exercise, I simply use the VO2 Fast model, because for what we are doing, it produces good results without needing to use very many credits. It's also important that you understand that credits are used not for each of this entire generation section as a whole that it's made, but for each video that it's produced. For example, here I have two videos, and why? Because I put here two outputs per prompt, so 10 credits, but multiply it by 2. So in this generation, we're going to spend 20 credits, and if we put 4, we're going to spend 40. And you have to keep all this in mind to avoid spending all your credits very quickly. So here we already have our prompt configured, we have our image configured, and in the AI model we have VO2, one output per prompt. I clicked, and what happened was that the creation of this video existed, the one we have here. And the result is quite interesting. The clouds are moving, the trees move a bit behind, some birds pass by, it becomes night, it really looks very good. But let's explore what other thing we can do here. We're going to delete this prompt, and we're going to add this one I have here that I've made before. And what I did here, what I wanted in addition to what happened, is to slowly move the house, slowly move the camera a bit outward, and also turn on the house lights. I want the lights of the house to now be visible from inside. So in addition to this change, I added a new function, which is what we have here. We can control the camera movement, not so much by what we say in the prompt, but this little button we have here, which is the one that allows us to generate camera movements with preset adjustments that we already have here. Save thanks to the Google Teams that add this here, so you can see the different camera movement that we can usually add to our videos. And depending on which one we choose, well, that's exactly what's going to do. And in this case, the one that was chosen, the dolly out, that's why the camera is going to move away. Once I chose to generate, it produces a video that we have here. Let's analyze it. Look that the camera is moving away slowly. All this content that's here is completely artificial because, well, the original image didn't have it. And the house lights, we'll see, that's actually giving us a somewhat strange result. I've noticed that VO, the system, or at least VO's, the system 2, is a bit clumsy when it comes to adding this lighting theme in the house that we have here in our project. However, I've explored a new way that can also help us to achieve a realistic or a more realistic result like the one we saw we produced at the beginning of this video. So for that, we're going to analyze this third prompt that I created, with which I generated two different animations. So the text prompt we write here is exactly the same as we had put at the beginning. However, what changed first is that I removed the camera movement to be able to maintain greater aesthetics, since sometimes what the AI generates when moving away can look a little fake depending on what we're doing. In this case, I left it to static camera, so we will have a much more interesting result. And I added a last frame, that is, now we only have a first frame, which is the original image from the beginning. There, our animation will start, but I have a last frame, a final image, which what it means is this is going to slowly transform into this. The AI will allow us to generate an animation between those two frames. You could, well, if you have the capacity and also the time within your rendering software, try to generate the night image. However, I've also created it with AI tools from the original image. Here, you will find a link so you can see a video about how I use OpenAI tools from ChatGPT, Sora, to be able to convert this day image to a night scene. Equally, at the end of this video, you'll have a link to be able to view it. However, once you have already have what that change is that you want to make from the first to the last frame, have your prompt configured, always check what model you are using and how many outputs, because I think the output per prompt is sometimes set a bit higher In this case, the output per prompt was going to be 2. I generated the animation, and here is what we will get. A very good looking result. I love how the clouds are passing, how the lighting changes, and little by little the house lights turn on. Here we have another alternative that we have created, so it generates several results and we choose the one we like the most. How incredible how this scene was developed that we have here. Important, once you have finished using it, you can press this button to download, and you'll be able to download a version up to 180p. If you need a much higher resolution, well, at this moment it's necessary to use other upscale tools that exist in the market. One of the most incredible that exists is timelapse, which has a high price, but it's very good. And remind, if you think this is not good enough, just keep in mind that this technology is not going away. It will just continue improving, so it's good to know how to use it.